And now I have a surprise for you, David. We have a famous young singer who is going to come over here and introduce herself to American television audiences. This is Adelina Medlina. Hello, darling. How are you?
How are you doing?
Oh, have a seat.
How are you?
This is the...
Nice to see you.
That's called Bisou en français. Have a seat, Elena. And I just wanted, because I just thought, yeah, sit there. I just thought, because you're this wonderful young singer who I thought was French. That's why we're in this French patisserie. I thought she was French, but she's not. Also, she lives nowhere near here, so that's why we're in this whole... But I just thought, you're talking about one of the greatest American singers ever, and this is a young lady who's going to be one of the greatest singers of tomorrow. And I wanted to just introduce you on the air and and talk about singing. And,
let me say something. The response to your performing just a week and a half ago, I guess, in Scott and Barbara Siegel's show.
Broadway's Rising Stars.
John Simon, who was a very difficult critic, was just taken away by your performance, as were so many other people that were there and told me about it.
Thank you. I'm really excited until this time, this particular moment, because it's all as if a dream comes true.
Or should I not ask?
No, don't ask that. Don't ask me that. I'm somewhere in my 20s. I
17.
Oh, yes, 17. She's 17. I can vouch
when
for that.
She started.
But the thing is that Doris had a very different life from the image that she had. I don't know. Did you know anything about Doris Day growing up in Russia? You're Russian.
Yes. And actually, I've never heard about her in Russia.
Nothing. Which just goes to show.
Maybe it was just me. But I've heard about Liza Minnelli. I've heard about Edith Piaf. But
yeah, she sang Doris Day. Piaf. What was the name of the song?
If You Love Me, but
if you loved me, not If I Loved You, which is Rodgers and Hammerstein.
Yes.
Yeah, it's If You Love Me, and but I think you should pronounce this, Hymn à l'amour.
Hymn à l'amour.
Okay. So it's the real name of that song.
Yeah. It was she stopped the show cold. She blew the roof off the house. People were jumping out of their seats, screaming encore. And I just have to say, Scott Siegel would not let her take another encore, which would have, the whole audience would have stood up there.
We haven't really mentioned that the show is a show about up-and-coming stars, about young, new talent.
Right, who's never appeared before anywhere except at Town Hall. So that what we're talking about here with Doris Day, I mean, there's a certain life that singers have when they have a great gift, which you have. You just have to take our words for it, because you'll have to go somewhere and pay to hear her sing, because she's not going to do it today. She's just going to talk with David about singing and about singers' lives. You know, they have, sometimes they have difficult lives, but you're thinking about opera now?
Well, yes. I'm going to continue my studies, and now I'm going to pursue master's as an opera singer. So, but it does make any difference, because both worlds are equally interesting for me.
Oh, okay.
So,
because Doris was a pop singer. What David is saying in this book, which is a very serious biography, is that she was undervalued as a singer and as an actress, right?
Yes, but I think more as an actress than as... I think that she was more recognized as a singer, although her voice is considered by a lot of the professionals so much better than many people realize. Because she was so popular, she was number one. She is, to this day, the number one female movie star of all time, the only one who was number one for 4 years in a row. And she was number one female singing star throughout the world for years, too.
Now, let's name some famous songs that she sang. Maybe you've heard of them, like Que Sera Sera. Did you ever hear of that song?
Her biggest song is Que Sera Sera, which is...
Que Sera Sera, whatever will be, will be. The future's not ours to see. Que Sera Sera. Yes, I sing, too. I'm dying to make an album. Thank you. Throw money, please.
She originated Doris.
He's never sung in his life before, by the way.
That's not true. I was the president of my high school choir.
Oh, horrifying news. That was in Cincinnati.
I'm from Cleveland. Doris is from Cincinnati. Right. I'm from Cleveland. Both in Ohio.
Both in Ohio. That's what it is.
In any event,
you have to know where Ohio is.
Que sera, sera was
not
a song.
Not yet. What do you say, right?
You'll be performing there eventually.
It's in the U.S.
It's in the middle of the country, the Midwest.
So you were in the choir. I was, too.
I was also a thespian. I was an actor in school.
Not that we need to know that to know how much how good this book is, which is just, and there's so many wonderful pictures, and you emphasize, much to my surprise, the fan clubs and her fans.
Well, there's a very important reason for that. The first priority.
Because they'll all buy the book.
No, it's because I think probably more than anybody else I'm aware of, any other star, Doris really cultivated her fans. She responded to them. I've met two fans, one of whom wrote her a letter when he was 9 years old and saw her in the movie Please Don't.
And his name was?
Paul Brogan.
Paul, hit this site on YouTube, please.
And he had over 150 letters from Doris Day over the years. When he was in high school, she sent him a typewriter so he could type his letters to her.
Wow.
And another reason the fans are so important, three of her British fans, where she continues to be even bigger, I think, than she is here, they came and moved in with Doris and lived with her for two
and
women.
Her assistants or something.
Yes, taking care of everything. A lot of the animals, actually.
For 40 pets or something. And the one thing, I had to get this in because you told me this and it hasn't turned up anywhere else in any interview so far, is that you found this woman's archives from Photoplay magazine, which nobody else knew about.
Well,
and there were hundreds of
different magazines. Her name is Jane Ardmore. And
yes, let's hear it for the late Jane Ardmore.
She became a friend of Doris's, actually. She would visit. Doris would go over to her house, not even to be interviewed. But the point is Jane Ardmore interviewed her for over, I think, basically a 15-year period of her career. And because Marty Melcher controlled everything that was published about his wife, Doris felt very free to say exactly what she was feeling because she knew it was going to be caught. But what this wonderful library, the Academy Awards Library, has in L.A., they have the Jane Ardmore papers, which includes all of the rough drafts, all of her working notes, all of the interview transcripts, all of the unpublished pieces, everything. And
which nobody knew about before or even looked at.
Ardmore's and Jane Ardmore's heirs gave me complete permission to quote from them. And
her heirs, not her hairs.
Yes,
oh,
heirs.
God,
and I,
an author here.
Well, pronunciation is maybe not my forte, but writing is something else. In any event, I quote at length from them, and I consider that to be the true memoir. She did write her memoir with A.E. Hotchner in 1975, but I think that was looking back at her life and career. What Jane Ardmore managed to get from her was her true feelings as she was living her career, about past, the present, and the future.
Which is what informs this book and makes it so captivating and delightful and readable. Alina, will you come back on the next program and we'll talk more?
Absolutely, of course.
Oh, okay.
Don't get discombobulated.
Oh, I will try. Discombobulated is my favorite word.
Okay. Don't you get discombobulated either, David Kalman, by the success you're enjoying. Thank you so much for coming out here with Doris and bringing Doris Day with us and her spirit into the Le Marjolin Patisserie out here at 50-17 between 50th and 51st Streets in Woodside, Queens. I love it out here. Okay. Au revoir.
I'm going to read this book today.
Okay. It'll be hard to do in one day.
Right. Well,
I will try.
She'll do it.